We're in Nashville, but commitment news on Wednesday as the Vols pick up another big-time commitment as Tennessee's class continues to roll forward for 2024. Caleb Giroux and Caleb Calhoun are here. Let me start with you. Giroux, what do you think of Mike Matthews as a pickup? What do we need to know about him?
Yeah, he's probably one of the biggest pickups in this class. He was a target for Tennessee since he was on the market. And really, as soon as Tennessee came out of the race sort of with Ryan Wingo, Mike Matthews was a five-star wide receiver out of Georgia. He'll fit perfectly in this offense, an offense that'll have receivers leaving this year and they need to add depth. He ranks as the number 13th prospect in the nation by 247 Sports Composite. So he's probably going to be the highest ranked guy in this class. And he could be a guy that bolts his class into the top 10 in the month of July. We're not even to the day of a lot of commitments yet.
That would be huge. And it will certainly bring a lot of momentum to the class. I visited with Chris Lowe of ESPN. And he said that's kind of the next step is stacking these two and three classes of top talent so you get top depth. Of course, the transfer portal is part of that. Like Georgia, for instance, they don't really have to use the transfer portal. I think that's where everybody would like to be eventually. Tennessee's probably not there yet, but if you can stack two or three of those classes, you can get there.
Yeah, and a big thing is stacking these classes together so that way you can use the portal to fill needs as instead of using the portal to make a whole recruiting class. And we see every coach at SEC Media Days really talking about when they're asked about the portal, it's a way to supplement. Nick Saban said they brought in five transfers, and all five are guys where they needed depth and they needed guys who can play on the field right now. You don't see successful programs usually using the transfer portal to bring in a lot of guys to fill depth. So really, you stack on those classes. We see hypo recruiting quarterbacks. Now if you can start recruiting some wide receivers and stack a couple wide receiver classes together, get some more big guys up front, then there's no reason to see why he wouldn't have depth and be able to have success here in the future.
Well, certainly, Caleb Calhoun, your impressions of SEC Media Days and who we'll visit with on the program today. Pretty stacked, if we do say so ourselves.
Yeah, I thought we did a pretty good job. We're also doing awesome on the pool, guys. Not to make all y'all jealous.
Yes, a little bit of pool duty as well.
Before turning to SEC Media Days, I wanted to talk a little bit about Matthews, though, Joe, because this comes right after Braylon Staley committed. And Braylon Staley's a slot guy. Matthews is a wideout. All of a sudden, we're looking at a Tennessee team that's got the perfect combination of receivers for the future already when Squirrel White's only a sophomore. I mean, and so are we getting at a level where Heupel, while there's questions over how he uses the transfer portal and who he recruits, at least at wide receiver, he's going to be able to recruit with Georgias and Alabamas and anybody he wants now, isn't he?
I would assume so. What wide receiver would not want to play in an offense like Josh Heupel's where you're set up for success? It's a one-read offense, and you have these choice routes where you can get yourself open and get yourself yards. And you know that Heupel's going to recruit quarterbacks. So it's a lot easier to pitch to a guy like Mike Matthews where you say, hey, we have Nico Iamaleava sitting behind Joe Milton ready to play. And behind Nico, we have Jake Merklinger who's going to come in your class and be ready to play. And you have those quarterbacks recruiting wide receivers and guys in these classes. And you do have success. You're going to have a wide receiver factory. And the only thing left, really, Calhoun, is for a wide receiver to make it big in the NFL so Heupel can add that to his list of, hey, if you come here, not only will you get yards in college, but look at Cedric Tillman or Jalin Hyatt, you'll get yards in the NFL too. And I think we're seeing that now with Braylon Staley and Mike Matthews, two highly ranked wide receivers in this class.
So we will have, I think a big part of that, before I change gears here, I think a big part of that too, not to say it affected Matthews' decision, I thought he was Tennessee all along, but you do have that NCAA specter that's not hanging over Tennessee anymore with the postseason ban. Never thought they were going to get one, but I guarantee you it was being used against them in recruiting.